Now I am moving to the trait theories. Here there is no classification like the previously what the psychosis did, like introvert, extrovert, or the melancholic, sanguine. This kind of any specific classification is not there. But here they are much focusing on the levels of traits. Levels of traits is nothing but the character. So we have some kind of personality character, personality traits, no? So that characters, the level is there. Normally the traits having the bipolar. Suppose if I talking to the honesty, what is the opposite of the honesty? What is the opposite of the honesty? So what is the opposite of the honesty? There is a level is there. Honesty, then dishonesty. There is a two end. One is a positive end, other one is a negative end. So here the traits is talking about the level only, not in the classifications. So here some of the psychology focusing the people's personality based on the level of temperament, or level of traits. Here none of the psychos not debating the people based on the traits, based on the characteristics. They not classify the people. Here the psychologists, they describing or they came, they write something related to the level of the temperament or level of the traits or level of the characteristics of the people. Normally the traits have the two end. One is a positive end, other one is a negative end. See this case of for example, satisfied, unsatisfied. So there is a two end is there, no? This is satisfied is like our attitude only. So some people having this good attitude, some people having the bad attitudes. If we have any variable having the two end, these are the variables we meet it as a trait variables in the case of the psychologist. And here they are not making any kind of classifications in the theory, but they're compiling the traits into the order only, the level of order of the traits only, not in the names like endomorphic, ectomorphic, or mesomorphic. Here the classification made with the use of the level, but they could not make any kind of unique name. What is exactly type theory? So the type theory and trait theory, there is a small difference or the. In the case of the type theory, we can classify the people based on the type, based on the people's some characteristics based, we may divide the people's classification. That classification may be in the case of physics and temperament. There is association between the physics and temperament. There is association between the facial reaction and temperament. From this, they classify the people into different category. Therefore, it's called as a type approach. I hope you understand. The type approach is like a psychological classification, but different types of it. Here, they're much focusing on the people's classification. But the trait approach, see, I'm talking about the trait now. It is also the classification only. But the classification men here as they are different levels, not for the people's classifications or the people's types classification and all. Here we are checking about the levels of the people's temperament, the traits, the character only. We could not go for any kind of classifications according to the trait approach. It's only the we are checking the level of traits, like how much the particular traits having, whether they are his honesty or somewhere honesty or his not honesty. Like that, measuring the level of the honesty traits only. I hope you understand. The same thing in the case of the Carl Jung. What's the Carl Jung highlighting in the sense? According to the Carl Jung, he highlighted the people into two categories, introvert and extrovert. It is a classification of the people. Introvert is one group of people. Extrovert is another group of people. Apparently, the other, Carl Jung, some of the psychologists, they tell the unique name as the ambivert also. Some people, they may in between the both the people. So there is a classification based on the peoples. But the trait theory is talking about the characteristics. What is the characteristics of the introvert? That is called introversion. It is not the characteristics of people, it is a character of the people. Introversion. Then for the extrovert people, they committed the traits as extroversion. So this is called as here traits. There's a two extreme end, introversion and extroversion. So this kind of classification, the level of classification is called as a trait approach. I hope you understand the difference between the type and trait. The type approach, it's a classification based on the people. with the different classification. Maybe the classifications suggested by the different authors, like there is a association between the face reaction as well as the temperament. Sometimes there is a association between the body structure as well as the temperament. Like that, they coin some of the unique characteristics, unique classification. They given some kind of unique name in it. But in the case of the trait approach, none of the psychologists are not suggesting any kind of the people's divisions. They highlighting the levels of the traits only. Now I move to the example. There is a two people here saying. So this guy name is called just I'm for the example. He's a Sanjay. He's a Shweta. So what he did, he beat her. So he beat her. Suppose if you are this type approach psychologist, how we can come for conclusions about these two people in the, based on the type approach? Just I'm going to highlight how the type approach may happen. Normally we may treat the Sanjay as a choleric in the case of type approach. So who's highlight the choleric? Which psychologist highlight the choleric stuff? Anyone can highlight. In which theory the choleric, the word is there in the type approach?
Gallant theory.
So choleric means those are very much angry. Here they're not talking about the traits. Here talking about the names of the person, the classification of the person is a choleric. Then mesomorphic. Where you can find the word mesomorphic? Who highlight the word mesomorphic? Which psychologist highlight the
Sheldon?
Exactly, Sheldon. Okay. So mesomorphic means what is the characteristic in the body language for him? The body structure is like a sports person, like a normal body structure. So in this classification, suppose you are the type of psychologist, you may conclude any interpretations like this only. He may be choleric or mesomorphic, that's why he's doodled like this. In the case of the Shweta, she's a melancholic. So she's always a crying nature. So this also suggests by the Gallant. So normally the type approach people may conclude this in this level only. They may classify the people based on the body type or based on the facial expressions. But in the case of the trait approach, how the trait approach done? See, I'm using the same name. His name is Sanjay. His name has Shweta. But in the case of the Sanjay behavior, if the trait approach people, they are observing the sense, they may interpret like this. I already mentioned that here the trait approach talking about his character, the traits only, the level of character. So what he's doing normally is the aggressive character. Therefore, the first thing is aggressive. It's a trait of him. The second one is his hot temper. Then him is the undisciplined. That is why this kind of issues is made to her, to the Shweta. In the case of Shweta, she's innocent, okay? Or we can come for, she's always having the fear. So fear, this is some kind of traits we can come for conclusion about the two persons. So here, any of the psychologists not making any kind of grouping about his character. Only we can highlight the psychologist may highlighting the people's traits only. So I hope now you understand the difference between the type and trait. Do you have any doubts? Please, otherwise I can move it next level. So the type approach is a classification of the people. The trait approach, it's also classification, but different levels of the traits of the temperament. The levels only may differ. Do you have any doubts between the type and trait approach?
No, sir.
Okay, thank you. To all of you, my screen. Yeah, so my screen is visible. Yes, the personality traits are enduring patterns of perceiving, relating to, and thinking about the environment, and ones that are exhibited in a wide range of your social and personal context. This is a small definition of the personality traits. So the personality traits, as I already mentioned, that each one having the different personality level, and each one's differ to others. In this world, no two persons having the equal traits or equal level of personality. Each one's personality different to each individual's. This is a theory is talking about the trait approach. I hope you understand. The people, even the case of the type theory, we can combine the people's like introvert 10 people in the classroom, extrovert 10 people, like we can classify. But in the case of the trait approach, we cannot classify the people based on the level, because each individual having the unique level of temperament, unique level of the particular character. Therefore, none of the people is not equal in a single traits. This is a theory, and this is a things is focusing on the trait approach. Yeah, so these are the, some of the characteristics of the trait approach. Traits are relatively stable over time. So relatively stable. Sometimes even you can find some of the good people, like whenever you're thinking about the Abdul Kalam, immediately we may think about his simplicity. So it means we can, in the different environment or different places, we can observe the Abdul Kalam simplicity. So that is called his traits. His traits is the simplicity, and his down-earth, his cordial to all. So this kind of small characteristics we may observe from his daily basis, as well as the we can observe from the YouTube videos and all. So from this we can come for conclusion about his behavior or his status here. He's a very simple person, simplicity person. So here we are not categorizing that Abdul Kalam is introvert, extrovert. We are making come for conclusion about the Abdul Kalam based on his traits only. Next thing, the traits differ among the individual. This word is important. So here the trait approach is much focusing on the individual differences based on the traits. But in the case of the type approach, we can combine the peoples into different categories. So see this case, if you want to divide the people of our MR classroom, according to the Sheldon theory, we can classify into three people. One is ectomorphic, endomorphic, mesomorphic, based on this type, body type. So in the case of the endomorphic, there is a 5 people. In the case of the ectomorphic, there is 15 people. So we are classifying the 15 people in a single classification. But the trait theory is not possible, because the trait theory, even the 15 people you divide in the type theory, no, the 15 people have the unique difference in some kind of traits. That's only it's focusing the trait theory. And the traits are bipolar. This term is important. The bipolar means the two different end. One is a positive end, other one is a negative end. Suppose if you're talking about the anything, honesty, punctuality. See, I'm talking about the punctuality. So there is one small traits. If you're talking about the punctuality, some people are very poor in the punctuality. The same people, sometimes he is very good in the punctuality aspects. The levels may differ in different concern and different contexts, and it may differ from the each individual also. So there is a two different level end may be there. And the traits influence their behavior. Normally, this kind of traits, the collection of traits only decide the people's personality. Like you have the lot of traits. All the traits combined together only, it shows your personality. What is exactly your personality like this? That is called trait influence the behavior. Yes. In this trait approach, the first theory I am highlighting here is the Albert theory. What the Albert theory is highlighting? So who is Albert? So his full name is called Gordon Albert. So I hope you are seeing his photo. He's the man of Albert. He was born in the year November 11, 1897. He died in the October 9, 1967. He's a nationality, United States, and field is psychology only. That's why he contributed this kind of theory. And his alma mater is nothing but he's an alumni member of Harvard University. This is small things about him, Gordon Albert. But when you observe his contributions, we can come for conclusion that he was the pioneering psychologist, often referred to as one of the founder of the personality psychologist. And he's a modern psychologist too, because he lived in the 20th century. When you look into the type theories, most of the type theories is very old. Okay. And when he was live, in the year 20th century, that time a lot of famous psychologists they contributed, like our psychoanalysis theories by Freud. So he's also met this Freud, and he do some kind of discussion at that time. But he's strongly rejected that Gordon Albert. No, he strongly rejected the two of the dominant schools of thought of the psychology at that time when he was living. The two psychologists, one is called psychoanalysis theory as well as the behaviorism. The behaviorism is nothing but our Maslow theory. He's totally against. He rejects the two theories. because his favor of in the theory of psychoanalysis, you know, the id, ego, superego. So he highlighted that Freud, each one having the id characteristics, ego and the superego. So he's highlighting the three the dimension of our personality. But he's totally against. But his favor, that Gordon Allport is a favor, his own approach, that he stressed that the importance of the individual difference and situation variable. He much focusing on the individual differences and situation variable. What is the individual differences and situation variable? See this case, when you go for any presentation, just I'm telling the small example. When you go for some presentation, some seminar presentations, the first time you may have some kind of very fear. The second time you don't have fear. The same, for example, you are teaching the same concept for the four times. The level of confidence may be increased in the fourth time. The first time you may have some kind of fear. The second time you have little fear. The third time somewhat okay. The fourth time you don't have a feel to face the mass audience because you are teaching the same content. So here, that is called the fear. The situation also main impact in this. For example, there is a difference between the when I'm taking the first class and when I'm taking the 10th times the class of you. Because you already cordial with me, I know who is each people, I know the pulse of the people. That's why some kind of closeness may happen. That situation, the situations of my interactions to be totally different from the when I discuss in the first time. There is a small lacuna may happen because I'm not knowing personally about you. That's why even I am not much about you now because we are already talked with online mode only. But even though, at least from your assignment task, your way of approaching, I can understand who is that particular guy, who is the boy, how he is, somewhat I can be able to predict it. So from the predictions, I can be able to lead my sessions in very much comfortably. This is for situation variable. This kind of situation variable, it also leads my the way of teaching and taking the classes. So that is why the Gordon Allport, no, he emphasized, he much stressed on the importance of the individual differences and the situation variable. And the next thing, the Allport theory, the personality emphasized the uniqueness of the individual and the internal cognitive and motivation process that influence the behavior. That term is important. For example, suppose I'm not familiar with the straight approach. I'm very poor. Suppose like cause of economics. So I'm not good in the commerce, I'm not good in the economics. That is called cognitive. I'm not good in the case of the cognitive aspects of the economics. Suppose I'm going to handle the classes for the commerce students, my motivation level should be reduced. Therefore, once the motivation level is reduced to teach them, normally what it happened, it reflect my behavior. The way of approaching the students is to be influencing. Therefore, my behavior may having some kind of issues when they observe from the end. So what it means in the sense, this theory only that Allport is focusing, the personality emphasized the uniqueness of the individual and the internal cognitive and motivation process that influence the behavior. For example, intelligence, temperament, habit, skills, these are the words may come to these things. And he highlighted in the 1937, the year 1937, I think, the year 1937, so because that is a time, he's an adolescent and he contribute a lot in this, in the year 1937, he believes that the personality is a biological determined by birth. Actually, the personality is started or determined by birth itself. It's determined by the birth, but in the biologically, but it's shaped by, there is a term. The from the birth itself, our from the biological origin is our personality origin. But the personality may shape during the environment, when you go for the get the environmental experiences. So they are mingling the two things. He strongly believed that the biology determined a birth and shaped by a person's environment experiences. These are the things only he highlighted. And see, in the year 1936, him and his friend Henry Allport, I think his name is Henry Allport, Allport, worked through two of the most comprehensive dictionaries of English language, available and extract around 80,000 personality descriptive words. So what they did know, him and his friend, he found a very good dictionary of the English language in the year 1936, and they found nearly 18,000 words related to the personality. From the 18,000 word, they filter it. They finally, it comes to 4,504 exactly, I'm telling that word he found 4,504. 4,504. So I put the 4,000 word only, but the exact, the number of words they compile is 4,504 words. All the 4,504 words, it's blank. It's related to the personality traits only. And he divided the 4,504 words into the three levels. The three levels of the traits. That only he focusing. He's not observing anyone. He is not doing an in-depth study about the trait approach. And what he did, he observed, he comprehensively compiling nearly 80,000 personality describing words. From the list, they filtered it into 4,504 words, personality describing objects. So this words is adjective-based, which they considered to describe observable and relative permanent personality traits. This is his contribution, 4,500 word he compiled related to the personality adjectives. Then finally, he divided these words into three classifications. The three classifications is not for the people's classification, the levels of the traits approach he classified. That name is cardinal traits, central traits, and secondary traits. So this is a number, so don't confuse with the number. This is a number I put. Just I'm going to discard the number is not one. So this is one, like three classifications of the based on the 4,500 words. One is the cardinal traits, this is the level, central traits and secondary traits. It is not the classification based on the people. He compiled the 4,500 words into three categories, three divisions based on the level. One is called cardinal traits, other one is central traits, then third one is the secondary traits. We will discuss one by one these traits. Before going to these traits, just I'm going to conduct a small survey poll for understanding these things. For this, I'm requesting you all to go to the Slido website, go to the Slido.com. From your answer only, I'm going to explain what is exactly the cardinal, what is exactly central and all. So just I'm going with the present in new tab. I request all to use your mobile phone, parallelly open, minimize your Google Meet. If you are using your laptop, you can open a new tab and type slido.com. Please, I hope you are seeing here slido.com. So if you need, I can type in the chat box also. Go to the slido.com. Slido.com. And type the word, code 44000. So kindly give this code, 44,000. 44,000. So I request all to join, then only I can come for conclusion about your traits. Yes, so just I'm going with the poll. Yes, the first question, what is your identity trait? So see, how we can give the answer in the sense, please kindly understand the question, after that you can write. Suppose someone's hearing about your name, immediately they can perceive some of the unique characteristics of you, like your identity characteristics. Suppose I'm talking about Mother Teresa, immediately what you recollect about the Mother Teresa, which is the example of peace. That peace is representing a Mother Teresa. The same manner, whenever the people hearing your news, your name, they immediately they recollect your some unique characteristics, like your meaning. So your name and the characteristics which may associate. Suppose I am talking about the Manmohan Singh. Immediately we are getting some kind of one important personal traits comes to our mind. That is the Manmohan Singh's identity. The same thing you have to write. What is your identity? Just you can observe it. What is the uniqueness traits of you? Kindly type in a word, not in a sentence. in your word here, can type what is your trait, identity trait. Some people are very courage. So that's some kind of, because someone's talking about one person, immediately they tell me, he's a very courage person, he's very bold. Like that, they're telling, you know, that unique characteristics. Calm and sweet, very good. So other, only one person's giving the answer. So it is your observation, but we can think about the others also. Kind, okay. Confident, very good. Only 4 persons are giving the responses. Then simple, confident, calm and sweet, confused. Oh, some people are thinking about use a term. Some people simple, very good. So here from this, I can understand that most of the people are simple. That is why I'm the particular word somewhat high. So Pragna is practical. Oh, so she's given the definition Pragna, practical. That's good. So whether other people may believe the same, that's a questionable. Thank you, Pragna, to your name with your identity. Organized, self-controlled, good, positive, bold and friendly. So I got only 13 responses, the remaining also you can share. So this is called as a cardinal traits. I hope now you understand. For each one, there is a identity characteristics. The characteristics, whenever the people are calling your name, immediately your unique characteristics may reflect their minds. So suppose I'm talking about Gandhi. What is the immediately you can feel? What is the immediate uniqueness characteristics you can check? Then immediately we are talking about Ahimsa. Ahimsa. Okay. So that kind of unique characteristics or unique traits we may equate it to the Gandhi. The same thing, each one's having some kind of unique identity. That unique identity is called to say cardinal traits. I hope you understand. The cardinal traits, it is the association, it is like the synonyms of your name. Each one having some kind of synonyms of your character with your name. So that synonym is, so whenever I'm talking about one person, suppose I'm talking about the Sinan Mohammed, immediately some unique characteristics it may reflect in my mind about this Sinan Mohammed. That characteristics is called identity traits. It is not in a single time it is not showing. He may show the particular traits regularly. Whenever I'm speaking, whenever I'm meeting him, I can find some kind of unique characteristics. That characteristics only his identity. That is called as a cardinal according to the alphabet. I hope now you understand what is cardinal. It is the synonymous of your identity. Your yes, the second pole. I move to the second pole. Rate your honesty level. So there is a honesty level 0 to 1 to 5. You can select your honesty level. I hope the second question may be visible to you. Kindly click and give the polling. Yes. So here I got the 12 responses. Out of 12 responses, 13 response, I can came to the 69% of people are very good in the honesty. 36% have only the 5-point rating scales. Okay, only and the other people's none of the people's not in the 0 level or 1 level or 2 level or 3 stars level. They are moving to the 4th and 5th level. It's good. This is called as a central. So what is called a central traits according to the alphabet in the sense? We have the different traits like intelligence. If they ask me the same question, what rate your interest, rate your intelligence level, rate your punctuality level. Like that, I am asking some of the questions related to the each traits. Here, the each traits compile, that is called building block. Normally, the building block, we have some kind of unique or some kind of good traits. That traits only is making us some kind of human being in this world. So this is basic traits, but there is a level differ. But this single trait, it's not a single trait, it's a collection of traits, but this is a builder. This much of traits may build our personality. So like honesty, intelligence, the punctuality, the loveliness, the happiness. So these are the small traits, it's make our own personality. This is called as a central traits according to the according to the Albert. I hope you understand. For each one's different level, but it's not a single, it's not identity of our traits. It is like lot of traits are there, like honesty, intelligence, then social maturity. So all together it's compiling the different traits, making our personality. So this combined together is called as a central traits. The last one, just I'm moving the last question to you. You have to give the questions answer. Are you comfortable to handle the classes for the mass audience? If yes or no, kindly share your reason. So kindly type. If you are yes, you can type. Suppose you are feel very comfortable, type yes and give the reason. If you are no, you can type no and give the reason. So you can yes, comma, yes, and then comma, you can give the reason. It's good. So kindly give the reason. So only one response I got. So what is the reason? Suppose when you go for taking any classes, whether you are comfortable to take the classes for the mass audience, and if you know, you can tell. So it seems no stage fear, very comfortable. If I'm preferred, very good. Yes, I love interact with the people. It's a great answer. So very comfortable. I'm preferred. So. Yes, I love to interact the people, very comfortable, lot of answers. Yes, I get motivated by people, I have to interact. So I love interacting with the different kinds of people, listening to different views and experiences by Sana is good. Others, I love to interact with people, very good. Yes, love teaching, good. So the love teaching, this is influencing, it's influencing your the way of teaching. So that is why the Albert highlighting that this kind of social variable, some kind of background variable also may influence our behavior. Suppose I don't like to teach, what it happened? The way of teaching is to be wrong, and from the way of teaching, the people may perceiving our behaviors and all. Okay, even the students like you, you can predict the teacher's personality based on the way of teaching from our end. So because you don't have the direct link with us, we are teaching only for 1.5 hours per week. From this only you are observing, you are measuring our things. Okay, suppose I'm not competent in this, on the particular topic, you may feel that it's very bad and all. If I'm good in this, you may think it's a very good teacher. So like that, different opinions may come about one person based on the teaching itself. So, but the teaching, here I'm teaching only, you're measuring the teaching, but immediately you are come for any conclusion about my personal touch parallel things. So that is the things he's focusing. Who's Albert? He's thinking that our cognitive intelligence and individual differences as well as the social behavior may influence it. Okay, Abdul, go to the mosque, no issue. So those want to leave, you can leave this. Yes, this is called as here, this is the third example, which I'm highlighting here as a example of the secondary traits. So this kind of behavior, you could not be crossed daily because are you comfortable to handle the classes in this mass audience in the sense, you are not regularly meeting the audience. It's like some kind of, sometimes only may have this kind of small situation. Suppose you are teaching the mass audience with a different, you are not familiar with these people. Therefore, your confidence level is somewhat less. If you are very comfortable with some group people, your confidence levels may increase. So in this case, some kind of specific time, it is not happen regularly. Our fear, our boldness, based on the situations, it may differ. Based on the situation, some of the traits may be differ. That is talking about these secondary traits. So now I move to the presentation. I hope now you understand the three examples of the traits. One is the central traits, coordinate traits, center traits, and secondary traits. Just I'm going to brief it the one by one. What is the coordinate traits? The coordinate traits, it's the traits that dominate an individual's entire life. As I already mentioned, if you're talking about the Abraham Lincoln, immediately we come for the conclusion about the honesty. If you're talking about the Mother Teresa, we are talking about the peace. We are thinking about the peace. That is the identity of the peoples. So each of the living being, like the man's, that is called as Oftentimes, the individual would become known. So these traits may and people with such personality often become so known for these traits that their names are often synonymous with these qualities. Alford suggests that these traits were rare and mainly developed later on in life. Cognitive traits are the fundamental to the direction of all the people's life. So this is suggested by Alford only. So this is talking about the Albert, the first theory, the first traits. And also, he's maintained that define a person to such an extent that the names become the synonymous with their personality. This is the main terms he highlighted. So when you're talking about the cardinal, the person's characteristics, it's equal to, it's a synonymous of his name. In this mindset, the people may come for this. That is called coordinate traits. The second one is the central traits. It's general characteristics that form a basic foundation of personality. And general characteristics found some degree. I already mentioned the traits is some degree in each person only. While central traits are not as dominating as the coordinate traits, they describe the major characteristics you might use to describe the other person also. For example, in the case of the intelligence, honesty, shy, anxious, it's considered as we are perceiving these things from some others. The same thing other people may be expecting us. Generally, each one having the 5 to 10 center traits. So these 5 to 10 center traits only is deciding the people's personality. So that's why I told this traits is called as a building block for the people's. The last one, the traits is called secondary traits. The basic traits of the secondary trait here are highlighting some of the attitudes, preferences, and often appear some of the states. No, it may appear only the certain situation only, and under certain events only. We cannot be predict. We cannot see some of the things like attitudes, situations, things. We cannot observe regularly to the people. Only some kind of event or sometimes we may perceive. Sometimes you may angry to someone. Sometimes you may not be angry with someone. So the based on the situation only the angriness you are showing. Suppose while it's seeing you first time, that time you are fighting with someone, then immediately I think that you are angry, very aggressive. But it's not exactly correct because that day, that situation may force you to angry with someone. So that kind of situational approach, we cannot come for any conclusion about the person. But there is a small influence of the secondary traits also. The secondary traits are seen only this specific situation like stage fear before speaking at public, impatient while waiting in line. So these are the things we can find in sometimes only. So this is a theory said by the the great man Albert only. I hope now we understand the things about the Albert theory. Just to be once again the concluding part of this theory. The trait theory, according to the Alford, he suggests that the individual personality are composed broad dispositions. It is also based mainly on difference between the individual. That's all. He already highlighted that the individual differences as well as the situational variable may influence on the behavior. The combinations and interaction of various traits form the personality. This also is believed. The combinations and interactions of the various traits forms the personality. That is unique to each individual. This theory, particularly this theory, is focused on identifying and measuring this individual personality into characteristics. That is why he suggests that there's a three traits. One is a cardinal, central traits, and secondary traits. The cardinal traits is for the uniqueness, the identity of the people. The central traits, each one having 5 to 10. These traits only making some kind of personality identity, some kind of personality building is happening because of the traits. The last traits is called these traits we may observe only some kind of specific situation, we cannot be observed regularly. So thank you.